Welcome to Puerto Vallarta, Mexico for the nightcap of day two of the Puerto Vallarta College Challenge. And what a game we have. A battle between the Pac-12 and the Big 12. Three-time defending national champion Oklahoma Sooners take on the Washington Huskies. We are happy to have you with us, everyone. Tracy Warren, along with former Olympian Kat Osterman and our entire Flow Sports crew. This is going to be a fantastic game. Both of these teams coming in undefeated. Oklahoma outscoring their opponent so far 16-0. Washington outscoring their opponents 12-3. In the season series between these two teams, it is knotted at 15. Oklahoma will be the visitors in this game, with Washington in the circle, going with Lindsay Lopez, the senior, to face the Oklahoma Sooners.
Well, Lindsay Lopez is going to be a different look against this Oklahoma lineup. They will throw anywhere between 5 to 7 lefties in their hitting lineup. Coach Tarr, pitching coach Lance Glasso, going with Lindsay Lopez to probably combat the lefty-on-lefty matchup that usually favors a pitcher, but Lopez is going to use her curveball away from these lefties. You'll see a rise, a change, and a drop mixed in. A big start here for the senior in the circle.
For the Oklahoma Sooners, which are coming in red hot, as we mentioned, they are outscoring their opponents 16-0 so far in this tournament. Jada Coleman set to let it off. The lefty senior will play center field. She is followed by Ella Parker, Tiari Jennings, Elisa Brito, Kinsey Hansen, Cassidy Pickering, who had the grand slam in game one, Sanders, Torres, and Riley Boone. Strike one by Lindsay Lopez. Lopez, a transfer at Arizona State, went to Washington after a coaching change with Arizona State. She has been effective for Heather Tarr, who has her work cut out for her, to the right side, and Jada Coleman is safely aboard to lead off this game for the Sooners.
Well, Lindsay Lopez trying to use that changeup early against Jada Coleman, but Jada Coleman has such good hand-eye coordination. She is able to get to a lot of balls outside of the strike zone and flip them in for base hits. That's not the hardest hit you'll see off the bat of Jada Coleman, but she's able to lead off this game and give the Sooners a chance from the get-go.
Ella Parker, one of two freshmen in this starting lineup for Patty Gasso, who is in her 30th season at the helm of Oklahoma. She is the third all-time winningest coach so far, just passing Margie Wright. She's behind Hutch in Michigan and Mike Pandrea at Arizona. Both coaches retired. 0-2 now to Ella Parker.
Lindsay Lopez going right after the freshman Ella Parker. Saw a backdoor curveball, a curveball away. Rise ball there. She's going to try to stretch the zone and see how far out she can get the freshman to chase.
As you can hear, the Sooner faithful have traveled to Puerto Vallarta, Mexico to cheer on their three-time defending national champion Oklahoma softball team. And there is the first strikeout for Lindsay Lopez.
That's the curveball away to a left-handed hitter. It's going to have a much sharper break than if a righty was throwing a screwball to these left-handed hitters. It's going to be a different look than what these lefties for OU's lineup have seen thus far in season. Still really early, but they haven't faced a left-handed pitcher with movement like Lindsay Lopez.
Tiari Jennings to the outfield. And that'll be caught by Alana Johnson for the second out of the inning. Senior Alyssa Brito steps in as the number four hitter for the seniors, for the Spooners. Patty Gassa said, we have 10 seniors and Brito is one of them. And she said she hopes fans enjoy them because they have just been amazingly talented, bringing championship after championship after championship to Norman, Oklahoma.
Brito, a transfer from Oregon as well after her freshman year, but came in, actually played left field at first in order to get in the lineup with the Sooners. Found herself in the infield last year, but this senior class is something special, and Oklahoma Sooner fans are in for a real treat as they send these 10 athletes out.
Brito, preseason All Big 12 in 2024. She was a unanimous first-team All-American last year. 2-1 count. Ball high out of the zone. Oklahoma has won 55 straight games dating back to February 24th, 2023. They own the longest winning streak in NCAA Division I history, and have now tied the all-division record held by then Division II program, Western Kentucky. First walk given up by Lopez.
So when you talk about the national scene for softball, especially Division I, OU hasn't just been good. They have been dominant. You talk about the stretches of wins. And there's been one win in there to break up what could have probably been a 100-plus game winning streak in both seasons. But that's just, everyone is playing catch-up to the Sooners right now.
Kinsey Hansen, graduate student. Batting number five for Patty Gasso Sooners. If you watch some videos about her, she is much into weightlifting, says she might even want to be a strength and conditioning coach post-career. Loves to work out in the weight room.
They just had her mic'd up the other day and she said something about it being a leg day, and I'm pretty sure she was single leg squatting over 100 pounds, so she's going to be able to be an impact if that is indeed the avenue she goes.
To the right side, and that is through. One run will score, and the Sooners have gone ahead 1-0 here in the top of the first. RBI for Kinsey Hansen.
Hansen did a great job with that off-speed pitch. Just poking it right through the middle of the infield.
Pickering had the grand slam home run in game one against Utah Valley. Let the faithful of Sooners exhale. It was her first at-bat in a Sooner uniform. Ball one.
Lopez doing a good job, especially against the lefties, of getting ahead. But when she's trying to stretch the zone right now, it's getting a little bit out of control. You see that one almost get away from Stewart back there behind the plate.
Lopez going to have to be able to rein in, stretching the plate in a quality manner as this game continues.
Pickering fouls that off. Out of Humble, Texas, she was ranked the number 4 prospect in the class of 2022 by Extra Innings Softball. Heavily recruited, but chose Oklahoma. To the left side, another run will score. 2-0, Oklahoma Sooners, RBI, freshman Cassie Pickering.
Tracy, Cassie Pickering doesn't get in the box and swing like a freshman. She has some very veteran at-bats, not just the outcomes, but the way she approaches those at-bats. You talked about her grand slam, her first at-bat ever. She was in a 3-0 or a 3-1 count and still was able to put a really good swing on the first pitch that she swung at her entire college career. This at-bat gets down 2 strikes to Lindsay Lopez rather quickly, but still able to get a hard hit through that left side. Cassidy Pickering is going to be one of the best, the next big names for this Sooner lineup.
Sid Sanders, ball gets away, and the runners advance for Oklahoma, now with runners at second and third for Sid Sanders. Sanders, the transfer from Arizona State, facing her fourth teammate in Lopez. This was a team with Sid Sanders, Lopez, and Torres, which actually defeated, when they were at Arizona State, UCLA for the Pac-12 title. And show you how great they were. It was a year that Sanders was a first-team All-American. He fouls that back.
Sid Sanders was a freshman at that. To be a first-team All-American as a freshman just shows you what kind of numbers she put up. She was able to be the power threat in that Arizona State lineup. Lopez and Torres both were sophomores, but I remember Coach Ford describing Lopez as having that lefty magic.
And to your point, Kat, Sanders hit .425 and 21 home runs in her freshman year at Arizona State. And she's the number 7 hitter for Oklahoma, which lets you know how much power they have. The 3-1 pitch. Ball 4. And the Sooners have loaded the bases here in the top of the first.
The decision to go with Lindsay Lopez did not surprise me, simply because, as I mentioned, the lefty on lefty matchup. However, you have to imagine Washington has Ruby Malin getting warm, ready to go to keep this game close. Lopez has thrown some good pitches, but there are some that are just so far out of the zone. It looks like she's out of control a little bit. You don't know if it's nerves facing the number 1 team in the country or simply just a little bit of timing is off.
Alana Torres sends one to the outfield, and that will be caught by Johnson for the third out of the inning. But not before the Sooners can strike first. Pushing 2 across, Oklahoma leads Washington as we move to the bottom of the first, 2-0.
Introducing the all-new, all-electric Honda Prologue. Made to inspire the newest generation of dreamers. The all-new, all-electric Prologue from Honda.
Mm-hmm. Cole May has a 2-0 lead headed into the bottom of the first as Oklahoma leads Washington Huskies 2-0. Washington just coming off the 4-3 win over Utah Valley. They earlier beat Nebraska 8-0. Pat Osterman, are you surprised that Oklahoma struck so quickly?
I'm a little surprised. I really thought Lindsay Lopez might be able to keep the lefty hitters for Oklahoma off balance. Now, granted, it was the right-handed hitters that drove in the runs, so that lefty-on-lefty matchup worked a little bit, but I definitely thought Washington would be able to keep them at bay a little bit longer.
Brooklyn Carter leading off for the Washington Huskies. He was 3-for-4 against Utah Valley in the game earlier today. Carter chops it to short, quick throw to first, and Jennings gets Carter for the first out. Jillian Solis has moved up into the number two spot. The graduate second baseman transferred from San Diego State. Set to face Nicole May.
You have to imagine Coach Tarr made that flip, moving Holtorf down into the third spot, hoping that more runners would be on. Holtorf was hot last game, allowing her to get more RBIs if she's in the three hole rather than in the second spot.
And you think there's any thought to lefty-lefty, righty-righty-righty in facing May?
There could be, allowing your lefty power hitter to follow Carter and know what she's going to see right off the bat. But then also, similar to OU, your power RBI producers are all right-handed. Now, granted, Nicole May being right-handed, it's not near as an advantage. But also the left-handed Celis, if Carter's on, allows her to be able to bunt and sometimes even protect for the steal, being in Kinsey Hansen's way out there in the left-handed batter's box.
Well, that is the first walk for Nicole May. And that will bring up Riley Holtorf, the junior righty. So far in the Puerto Vallarta College Challenge, Oklahoma has held opponents to a 175 batting average. 7 hits, and all of them have been singled, while striking out 7.
Coach Gasso calls Nicole May the matriarch of this staff, and she is. She is the senior. She has been at OU her entire career. So in essence, she has earned this start through her time. They did add 2 other pitchers through the transfer portal this year, Kelly Maxwell and Kinney from Liberty, both who will get innings as the season goes, but Nicole May gonna be who they're gonna lean on unless they're proven otherwise.
Holtorf goes down for it, and that is caught by Jada Coleman. The All-American center fielder shows you why he's one of the best defensive center fielders in the game.
Well, Jada Coleman goes all out all the time. Holtorf does a great job with that off-speed pitch. Looks like she's gonna loop it into center field. But Jada Coleman, the big plays are routine for OU center fielder.
Sydney Stewart, the number 4 hitter for the Huskies, as they try to piece some offense together, the sophomore out of San Jose, California. And he will take first base, as now the Huskies have 2 runners aboard here in the bottom of the first.
Thank you. You see Kinzie Hansen calming Nicole May down. That wasn't a bad pitch. But Sydney Stewart's elbows hang a little bit low. I'm not going to say over the plate because they weren't over the plate, but they were enough in the river with that hit by pitch. Questionable when you're a pitcher.
With that bobble, quickly, Felice moves to third, and now the Huskies have runners at first and third with Alana Johnson, the sophomore, up at the plate. Coming into today's game, hitting 400 in the number five spot for the Huskies. More conversation in the circle.
Well, you see Sydney Stewart signaling to Coach Tarr that she got the call. I think Coach Tarr probably also asking her, why weren't you running if Celis ran ahead of you?
And 0 to Johnston. Two runners on. Ball up in the zone to the left side. And the Sooners get out of the inning. The Huskies threaten, but the Sooners hold on. We're headed to the top of the second. Oklahoma leads Washington 2-0. As we mentioned, the series between Oklahoma and Washington is tied at 15. Last year in Irvine, Oklahoma won 5-4 in a battle with Lopez and May in the circle. Washington homered early off Jordy Ball, and then May came in. The Sooners went on to just get hit after hit with Brito, a huge two-run home run off Lopez in the third. May then retired 10 of 14, and the Sooners won 5-4, but the series again tied at 15 between these two teams as Riley Boone, the number 9 hitter, in for the Sooners.
Well, these two programs have both been at the top of their games for a long time. Coach Tarr took over Washington, and almost essentially she got them back in the conversation. And we know Oklahoma's history, and with that, Riley Boone, another lefty, leads off with a hit for the Sooners.
You see the speed of Riley Boone and the great soft touch in laying down the bunt. Stewart just not quick enough to get the Speedy Boone, who is a leadoff base runner here in the top of the second. Jada Coleman singled and run scored as she'll talk things over with Coach Gasso. Patty Gasso has been electric in the world of softball. She is 3-time defending champion coach, has really brought national acclaim to Norman, Oklahoma, 16 College World Series, 23 Big 12 titles. They're building a new field. Love Field will open in just about 2 weeks at Norman. He's met with 3 different presidents of the United States, and there's another bunt.
Just a long 7 history for the Oklahoma Sooners. I'm listening to an interview with actually JT Gasso earlier this week. They talk about how they pass that history down. Jen Stewart was around the field, around the program recently, and they were pointing at her on the wall. She's the one who won the national championship in 2000. She was our first World Series MVP. They let their players know who built the program, but also what the tradition has always been. And they find the athletes that are going to buy into continuing the standard.
One and one to Jada Coleman. Fouls that off. JT Gasso, of course, is Patty Gasso's son, who is in charge of the hitting for Oklahoma. When we asked her what he brings to the table, except the obvious, and she said he's a great communicator. He is really Captain Science, she called him. He is into breathing, but he communicates with these athletes so well. And if you know anything about...
He's done a tremendous job.
You got it, Kat.
Oh, yeah, he's done a tremendous job. Chip McKay did a very good job prior to him, and then JT Gasso was handed the reins. And it's not necessarily recreating swings, but he's a great, as Coach Gasso mentioned, communicating data, and we can get into that more. But he's able to communicate to these athletes what pitches to expect and what counts, and that's where OU is very different. You see them adjust a little bit quicker based on counts and what a pitcher's tendencies are, I feel like, than other programs. But don't be fooled, though. He'll also tell you he's in charge of the outfield, and he might actually love coaching defense more than he does the offense.
Ella Parker with the runner on first and one out. Ball up. He worked under that for the second out of the inning. So two quick outs for the Sooners.
Now batting the shortstop, number 23, T.R.A. Jennings.
T.R.A. Jennings. Looking for her first hit of this game, coming into today's game hitting 600. That's funny you talk about.
Go ahead.
Great hitting. And Jennings is probably one of JT Gasser's best pupils. She just is a phenomenal hitter.
And that's what I was going to say as well. She's just been a consistent hitter from the beginning, and a lot of clutch hits, but it's the consistency that those clutch hits come at. They're not just sporadic. She has one of the best approaches of really pretty swing, but just has been able to be really consistent for this OU lineup.
Ball high and to the outfield, and that is caught by Carter for the third out of the inning. So Lopez starting to settle down as we head to the bottom of the second. Oklahoma up 2-0. 6, 7, and 8 for the Washington Huskies set to face Nicole May. Jaden Glab, one of the hottest hitters for the Huskies, coming into today's game batting 600. Just a freshman, will be the first to face Nicole May here in the bottom of the second.
Glab had a big double in the game earlier today against Utah Valley. So another young bat that Coach Tarr says she's going to ride with. She's not going to do a lot of changes to this lineup early. She wants them to get comfortable, confident, gel as a group. Other than switching them around in the order, she's allowing all of them to get there at bat.
Coach Tarr in her 20th season at the helm of Washington. They won the national championship in 2009. Her 725 winning percentage is 10th among current Division I head coaches. Been very active with the national team for softball. And we were talking to her about what she's learned about international play that she can bring to the Washington Huskies. And she said, look, we could raise our game. Just when you think you're good, you see the international play, and we can all up-level our game at Washington.
Well, Coach Tarr has been around the international game for a while, and she's had quite a few athletes that have played internationally as well. Victoria Hayward, who's on her staff now, has played for Team Canada for a long time. So a lot of different influences, not just from watching the competitors in Japan, but also having athletes that have been in programs. This is how we did it. This is how you can do something different.
Well, Nicole May gets her first strikeout. It is a big one in sitting down Jaden Glab.
Now batting for the Huskies, left fielder number 5, Avery Hobson.
Today has been the story of the changeups. We saw last game Utah Valley and Washington both utilizing the changeup quite a bit. Nicole May sits Glab down right there on a well-executed off-speed pitch.
Avery Hobson, the senior left fielder, transfer from Oklahoma State. Well, the Huskies' 2024 schedule includes 10 teams ranked in the top 25, including Oklahoma. Of course, they'll see lots in the Pac-12 and UCLA and Stanford. They'll also face Oklahoma State and Nebraska. We are still waiting to see the fate of Jordy Ball, who was injured in her first game for Nebraska, leaving after 2.1 innings. Cats, any update to her status?
Well, yeah, I saw on Twitter that they had actually released that Rhonda Revelle said it is her knee. They're going to treat it as serious until they get back to Lincoln. So basically, no way to evaluate it there in Puerto Vallarta. She is going to dress out, but we won't see her in games for the rest of the weekend. But it is her knee. Probably from the looks of it, it looked like she might have hyperextended it. But that knee injury is going to keep her out of the circle for the Huskers.
So a big blow to Nebraska, but Avery Hobson wins that battle. The second walk given up by Nicole May. She's a one-out base runner here in the bottom of the second. Brooke Nelson, who was in the circle, started last game, then moved to first base and is hitting number 8 spot, steps in. First pitch swinging. That drops in. And the Huskies have runners at first and second here in the bottom of the second.
I was gonna say, Avery Hobson is a dangerous hitter to walk because similar to Brooklyn Carter, she can take off and steal second rather easily, but no need to put the steal sign on when Brooke Nelson is gonna deposit the first pitch in there in left center field. Washington starting to make some adjustments to Nicole May, attacking her a little bit early in the count.
trying to get out ahead of her as opposed to letting her be able to mix speeds and mix locations.
Kinsey Fiedler, the number nine hitter, set to step in for Washington, and then the top of the order. Last year, the Huskies hit 298, 65. We watched Oklahoma just explode against Utah Valley for 13 runs in a five-run game and then really keep Duke at bay, winning 3-0. This has been their first true challenge as Brito walked in her first at-bat.
The last 2 years, OU has really gone on a run and been undefeated till late in season. And every time Coach Gasso talks about, sometimes losing is the best teacher. So games like this, she doesn't like to avoid them. She wants her team to be in situations where they're challenged, backs are up against the wall. And if sometimes a loss takes that sting is what has to turn them around, she's willing to accept it.
And what does she say in a lot of the videos you see is get comfortable with the uncomfortable. And she pushes her athletes till they feel uncomfortable, and that is oftentimes in situations like this where they've got a fight to come from behind. Brito, one of six seniors in this starting lineup for the Oklahoma Sooners.
As Lindsay Lopez settles in, she's getting these OU hitters guessing just a little bit. She got Brito with a changeup for strike one, extends the zone with a rise ball there. That rise ball is going to be a little tricky because it is coming up and in as it's coming from the left side of Lopez.
Lopez settled down in the second, gave up one single before three consecutive outs. 2-2 now to Brito. And that is ball four. Check it was 3-2. And that is ball four. The third walk given up by Lindsay Lopez.
Brito doing a good job of laying off the rise ball after she swung at it for strike two, but for Lindsay Lopez, that's almost the worst case scenario. You don't want to walk the leadoff, especially with Hansen and the hot hitting Pickering coming up in this inning.
Hansen going after the first pitch, pops that out, and that is caught for the first up out of the inning. The hot hitting Cassidy Pickering hitting 800 coming into this at bat.
Pickering just has veteran approaches to her at bats. She's not swinging out of the strike zone. She's been able to take advantage of when she's in hitters' counts.
You know you have to be good when Oklahoma has six seniors in the starting lineup, several out of the transfer portal, and you're a freshman who cracks the starting lineup, and you're leading all hitters batting 800 here in the early going.
Well, you don't get as good as Oklahoma is by not being able to recruit. Coach Gasso obviously having the top recruiting classes year in and year out, which just shows the way her and her staff are able to convince elite athletes. Yes, you want to win a national championship, but there are athletes on her roster that for the first year or two, they might not play as much as they would as another top program, but they come, they learn, they get better, they're ready to go. If you break the lineup as a freshman in Oklahoma, that's really saying something, Tracy.
She was the number four ranked prospect in the country out of high school.
You couple Cassidy Pickering and Ella Parker in a recruiting class, and that's a lot of heavy hitting for 4 years.
Second walk given up this inning by Lopez, and the Sooners have runners on first and second with one out. It is the fourth walk overall.
Lopez wanted that last pitch, but if there's a walk that might be an okay walk, it's right there to Cassidy Pickering, not allowing her to hit the ball hard, allow Brito to advance past second base. Sid Sanders and Alana Torres are two hitters that Lopez is very familiar with, as you mentioned, Tracy, earlier in this broadcast, all of them having played at ASU together.
Sid Sanders stepped in. She walked her first at bat. Out of San Marcos, California, her dad played minor league baseball for a number of teams. When Trisha Ford left Arizona State, so did Sid Sanders. She thought of Texas A&M, but she landed at Oklahoma. Of course, Trish Ford went to A&M. But it's tough to see all those championship trophies at Oklahoma and know that you have a chance to capture one, and they did just that last year. Two and one, former Sun Devil against former Sun Devil.
This matchup has me questioning, when they scrimmaged at ASU, what were the outcomes? Which one of them feels like they might have the upper hand?
That's a great point, because Sanders in her freshman year was just on fire. No one could stop her. Even Ferragnamo and UCLA struggled to handle Sid Sanders, and Lopez walking her the first time up, just approaching her very cautiously. It's 2-2 against Sid Sanders. Right side foul.
Well, when you're this familiar with a hitter, there are no secrets. Sid Sanders knows what Lindsay Lopez throws. She hasn't developed something new at Washington. And Lindsay Lopez, obviously having faced Sanders, but also seeing her over the course of the last year, knows what she's capable of. So it's really trying to outsmart each other. Can you not guess what's going to be thrown? Can you throw a pitch that she wouldn't expect you to throw?
That ball was up in the zone, and Stewart catches it for out number two. So a big out for Lopez. Elena Torres, another Sun Devil, playing second base today for the Sooners, steps in the number eight spot. She flew out to right field her first time up.
Torres swung at the first pitch, her first at bat. I would guess she's gonna be a little bit more patient, especially having watched two times through the order now, how many balls Lopez is throwing to these Sooner hitters.
Lopez has four walks and 2 2/3 innings. Another former Sun Devil on former Sun Devil matchup.
Right now, that changeup has been the most consistent pitch for Lopez. If I'm Oklahoma, at some point when I'm in a hitter's count, I'm going to start expecting that pitch because that's what they're using in order to get her back into the at-bat.
Ball is hit well to the fence, and that is caught. A great catch by Brooklyn Carter and saves a bunch of runs, holding Oklahoma. The Huskies on top as we move to the bottom of the third, 3-2.
This is 36.
This is 38.
This is 35.
A new age in skincare technology.
Well, a great catch by Brooklyn Carter robs Elena Torres of potentially a home run. And it's up to Nicole May, who will face 4, 5, and 6 for the Washington Huskies here in the bottom of the third. Tracy Warren along with
Cat. Go ahead.
You got it, Cat.
Well, that catch at the wall not only robbed Aaliyah Torres of a home run, but it washed her, but OU would have put up 3 more runs, so that would have been a 2-run differential. You saw Lindsay Lopez fist pumping and jumping on the mound as soon as that catch was made, but a great jump by Brooklyn Carter to save not just a home run, but 3 runs for this for the Huskies. Excuse me.
Sydney Stewart was hit by a pitch in her first at bat. You know, we talk with both of these coaching staffs, and they equate pitching in softball much to like baseball. You use relievers, you use middle relievers, and with the depth that both of these teams have in the circle, you wonder how long they go with the respective starters as we start to turn over the lineup and they see Nicole May a second time.
Well, and that'll be the question for Washington, too, as OU gets ready to come for their third time, is when is Ruby Malin possibly going to make an appearance? But Washington made an adjustment to May rather early. So you have to wonder if Kelly Maxwell's in the bullpen or one of their other 5 arms they have. They have Kirsten Deal, SJ Guerin, a number of arms to be able to rely on as season goes.
Did she go? Yes, she did. Otherwise, it was ball 4. So they got Stewart. Third strikeout for Nicole May.
What a great execution on that pitch. Full count, rise ball, knowing that Stewart's probably going to be aggressive, but out of the zone. Tried to hold up her swing. Could have been a leadoff walk for the Huskies. Instead, Nicole May, another strikeout.
Alana Johnson flew out to third in the first inning. The scoring for Washington has really come from the 7, 8, and top of the order. Johnson's got a lot of extra base potential for the Huskies. She's batting 333 coming into today's game. Sends it out to Jada Coleman, who gloves it for out number two. Glab to short, Jennings to first for the third out of the inning. So three up, three down for Nicole May. We're moving to the top of the fourth. Washington leading Oklahoma 3-2.
This is 36.
This is 38.
This is 35.
New age in skincare technology.
Ruby Malin is in for the Washington Huskies in the circle. She will spell Lindsay Lopez. Malin has been outstanding so far for the Washington Huskies in the circle, facing Nebraska, holding them scoreless with the 8-0 Washington win. Kat Osterman, what do you make of the pitching change here for Washington?
I think it was inevitable. We knew that this game was most likely going to be split between Lopez and Malin. It's about time. Lopez has thrown quite a few pitches. She's had a little bit of control issues in this game, so her pitch count got up there. OU is getting ready to come the third time through the lineup, so great time for Washington to go ahead and make a change. Ruby Malin is going to be who they rely on in the big games as this season continues. So what better way to get her feet wet in the 2024 season than right now to finish this game against the Sooners?
And as you mentioned, it's the third turn for the Oklahoma Sooners. Riley Boone is getting her second at bat, but then the top of the order, Boone singled in her first at bat.
To me, Boone is such an overlooked athlete down there in the nine hole. She does a great job of turning this lineup over, setting the table to allow Jada Coleman some free reign to not have to always get on base, but just not as talked about as some of these bigger names in this senior class.
Boone is a preseason All Big 12. Ranks fourth in program history with a .405 career batting average in 181 collegiate games. There is the bunt and foul ball. Boone was a College World Series All-Tournament Team.
Boone, like so many slappers, have just incredible speed. And she's able to find her way on in a multi different ways. You don't see her swing away a ton. She can. But a lot of times she'll try to use small ball, slap it through the hole.
Maylin gets her with the rise ball.
Right, as I said, she doesn't swing away very often. There she goes. Swinging, and Ruby Maylin able to record her first out.
Jada Coleman had a single in the first, scored a run, threw out to short in the second. First time facing Maylin this year, strike one.
Malin's going to come in and just attack the strike zone. She will pound the strike zone, work ahead, and then try to stretch. Lopez tried to work around the strike zone, came in with her changeup, and then tried to see if she could get the Sooners chasing. But Ruby Maylin throws upper 60s. The speed will be a big difference from Lopez as well. That could play a factor in her favor for the first time through against these Sooners.
Fouls that off. Maylin out of Nebraska is a preseason all Pac-12. She's out of Omaha. Had an outstanding College World Series last year. Poor Washington had five strikeouts versus Stanford in the College World Series. Helped her earn third team All-American. That ball is swung on, strike three, and Coleman takes first base. So she is safely aboard, but we've got a meeting with the umpires. Kat Osterman, foul tip. What are you thinking?
Well, it looked like it could have been, but the way Jada Coleman off made me believe that she doesn't feel like she touched it at all. It was getting away from the catcher. They're gonna award her first base, so no foul tip. Just wild pitch pass ball. Oklahoma has a runner on.
So Coleman is aboard after striking out and the pass ball. So just one out, that will bring up freshman Ella Parker. Parker looking for her first hit in this game. One of two freshmen in this lineup today, Pickering the other. Goes after the first pitch.
See Parker, knowing that Malin's pounding the zone, trying to be aggressive early. The key is to be on time and stay with that down pitch that Maylin throws. She has a good drop ball, and it's fairly heavy, so it's hard to stay through as a hitter.
How difficult is it for a freshman like Ella Parker to pick up a lot of the movement of Ruby Maylin?
It's the combination of the speed and the movement. Ella Parker has seen some elite pitching as she came up in travel ball prior to coming to college, but now it's that movement and that speed plus being able to locate really well. So it'll take a little bit of an adjustment, but this is a hitter. She's elite. She's seen a lot of good pitchers. But part of it's gonna be remaining calm too and not trying to do too much.
Remaining calm, it's something that the Oklahoma hitters tell them JT Gasso professes, remain calm, focus on your breathing, slow the process down. She's in the hole 0-2 against Malin with a runner on first. Just outside. Second strikeout for Ruby Malin. Coming with some low heat.
Ruby Malin saw Ella Parker chasing that drop ball. She was just barely getting it for foul balls and tried to stretch it for ball one, but went there again to make Ella Parker prove she could lay off it twice in a row. She could not. Big second out for Ruby Malin.
And Malin challenges Jennings upstairs. Jennings has popped up in her two at-bats. Jennings, one of the most dangerous hitters in all of college softball. She is a career 427 hitter with 73 home runs, 245 RBIs, and a second in program history in batting average, and Malin is challenging her.
You have to imagine that, one, Malin already knows everything Tiare Jennings is capable of, but the conversation with pitching coach Lance Glasso before she went out was, if you're in this situation, let's circle the hitters that we're going to go at them, but we're also going to be careful with them.
Maitland's precision here early on is phenomenal. I mean, the way she's hitting her spots, and she has to against Oklahoma because they make you pay. But she is that good this early.
She is hitting some really good spots right now, able to paint the outside corner against these hitters, and able to use the differential of her drop and rise to keep Oklahoma guessing.
And they get Jennings again. Oklahoma puts the runner on, but she's stranded. Washington stays on top, 3-2.
This is 38.
This is 35.
A new age in skincare technology.
We are back, and the Washington Huskies are ahead 3-2, and this is how the scoring started. A single, but obstruction called on Kinzie Hansen, and you see she is in the way of Hobson as she comes home. The Huskies would put up two more runs off the bat of Jillian Sellis, right down the first baseline off the glove of Sid Sanders, and that is where it stood since the second inning. Washington's coming to bat, looking to extend their lead.
And it is Avery Hobson who will set to lead it off here in the bottom of the fourth. She will face Nicole May. Hobson walked and scored that run on the obstruction call. It was the first run pushed across for Washington in the second. They went on to score two more and lead Oklahoma 3-2. Oklahoma is out hitting Washington 4-3 and has left seven runners on base compared to the Huskies 3. Chopper to the left side. Jenning can't handle it. And Hobson is aboard here in the bottom of the fourth.
Hobson having nearly identical games. Walked her first at bat, both here against OU, but also against Utah Valley. Then has her infield single.
Nelson to the left side, Jennings underneath, and grabs it for the first out of the inning.
Next up for Washington, third baseman number 20, Kinsey Fiedler.
Now in the second inning, Hobson led off with a walk. Brooke Nelson swung at the first pitch and got a single. You have to imagine somewhere in there, there's a conversation about giving Hobson time to possibly steal second base. The speed her and Carter have allows Washington to be able to run a little bit more freely. Granted, Kinsey Hansen is one of, if not the best catcher in the game. So the steal signal might not be given quite as much from Coach Tarr.
Kinsey Fiedler struck out looking her first time up. Chopped it. Hit and run was on. Safe all around. Fiedler beats it out. And the runners are on first and second for Washington.
Well, Fiedler is incredibly athletic, and she used her speed on this one. Chopper right in front of the plate, and Kinsey Hansen actually got out and fielded it well. Looked like she might have double clutched or had to re-grip before getting rid of that ball, allowing Fiedler to just beat it. But Washington having Carter up, a lot of speed.
Which is the top of the order for Washington. Carter comes into this at bat, the hottest hitting Husky in the tournament so far, batting .444. She is 1-for-2 today, as you see, Fiedler beat out that throw to first. And it looks like Patty Gasso is going to make a pitching change. Heather Tarr talking with her team. Heather Tarr talks about the 9 underclassmen that she is helping teach the sport of softball at an elite level, managing expectations. As it looks like Coach Gasso is going to leave Nicole May in the game. Two runners on, one out. Huskies lead by one and top of the order. Brooklyn Carter.
Tracy, when we first thought she was going to change pitchers, it made sense. Kelly Maxwell being left-handed is who I would think they would bring in.
You also have Kirsten Deal and SJ Guerin, who are all lefties. So you have three lefties to choose from and two lefties coming up in this order for Washington. Would have been a good matchup for her lefty pitchers.
Well, she's letting Nicole May and her defense work their way out of it. Fly ball to the left side. That is playable and caught for out number two. Riley Boone gloves it for the second out of the inning. Big out for the Sooners as Jillian Solis steps in. Solis walked in her first at bat and then had the two RBI single in the second.
Washington getting a little aggressive, starting to swing first pitch because Nicole May has been pounding the zone. Now she's stretching it early. You're going to have to rein back in, make sure they're focused in the in zone and what they can drive.
Amazing, the cat and mouse. When they're swinging first pitch, Nicole May then starts to throw it out of the zone. And then they're looking second pitch and she throws it out of the zone. So you're right, Kat Osterman. It has been just a game of cat and mouse between Washington and Oklahoma. Riley Hultorf on deck, the number three hitter.
Good patience by Celis right now.
Stays 2-2. Washington beat Nebraska 8-0. Beat Utah Valley earlier today 4-3. They have outscored their opponents 12-3 in the Puerto Vallarta College Challenge. They lead Oklahoma, the top seeded team in the nation, 3-2, with two runners on in the bottom of the fourth.
This is a very veteran at bat. Obviously, Jillian Solis, a grad transfer to Washington, but she is proving every bit to be the veteran in this at-bat here after going down 0-2 to Nicole May.
Runners were going. They will go again. The 3-2 pitch, runners in motion. Got her! Nicole May comes back and fights for another day. She holds the Huskies down. And now the Sooners get their opportunity. We move to the top of the fifth. Washington leads Oklahoma 3-2.
This is 36.
This is 38.
This is 35.
In skincare technology.
Well, credit Patty Gasso for leaving Nicole May in to fight her way out of the jam. And she did just that. The Sooners put the clamps on Washington, preventing additional scoring. And now the Sooners will bring up 4, 5, and 6. And there you see Patty Gasso and JT Gasso. JT, he and his wife expecting their fourth child in March. This will be his third girl. And talking to Patty Gasso, she said they planned it so that they will deliver on a day off. Always planning around softball.
Oh, you know, I could fall in that category, knowing last year that I was gonna have to have a C-section. We made sure we planned it around a broadcasting schedule. So if you can plan
it,
you might as well.
Yeah, you got priorities. Yep.
Yo.
Top of the fifth, Elisa Brito set to lead it off against Ruby Maitland.
I do think the interesting dynamic with Coach Patty Gasso and Coach JT Gasso is when you hear him talk about her, he does refer to her as coach, which I wonder how long it took him to say coach and not mom.
He and his brother DJ were always hanging out in the dugout when Patty started some 30 years ago at Oklahoma. DJ now with Arkansas after it was with Utah. Three and oh to Brito.
Great pitch right there by Maylin. Working the inner half. She's been working the outer half to these OU hitters quite a bit, but tucking it in there for strike one.
Gets her to pop up. After down 3-0, Ruby Maylin fights back and gets Brito to pop up to second for the first out here in the fifth.
That was a big out. Brito has walked twice, has been in control of both of her at-bats, and looked like she would be there again. But Maylin using that inner half of the plate.
Yeah, you look at this lineup, and it's like three waves of offense. You got in this wave, Brito, Hansen, and Pickering.
With a walk, Hansen with an RBI, and then Pickering followed with another one. But you're right, Tracy. You can divide this lineup up into three parts, and they all produce a little bit differently.
You could see in the first two games, Patty Gasso kind of giving everybody a shot, but in this third game, the deck is definitely stacked offensively for Oklahoma. One and two to Kinsey Hansen. You know, you go to travel to Norman, Oklahoma, and you go in their bookstore, and on the top level, it's not football jerseys you see that they're selling. It's softball jerseys. Kinsey Hansen's number is among those jerseys that's being sold. And they do such a good job of emphasizing women's athletics and the softball team in that bookstore. It's almost like the entire first level is softball. got her upstairs. Ruby Malin throwing some high heat and gets Kinsey Hansen upstairs for the second out of the inning.
Ruby Malin did such a great job of pounding the bottom part of the zone. Drop ball in, drop ball out. Tried to stretch the drop ball a little bit and then surprises Hansen with that rise ball to get strike three. A great sequence and great execution by the sophomore, Ruby Malin. Very impressed with how she's come into this game and been able to execute.
Going right at the freshman, Cassidy Pickering.
I do like the tempo and the poise of Ruby Malin. Obviously having a year under her belt of experience, but works at a good pace and really hasn't flinched at all on close calls or any possible situations of trouble.
One and two to the freshman Cassidy Pickering, who hit a grand slam home run in her first collegiate at bat against Utah Valley. She is down 1-2 against Ruby Malin. Sid Sanders on deck. Yeah! Got her! Ruby Malin, back-to-back strikeout. Her fifth of this game, and she's taking the bat out of the hands of the Schooner. We are moving to the bottom of the fifth. Washington leading Oklahoma 3-2.
This is 36.
This is 38.
This is 35.
Technology.
We have got ourselves a ball game in Puerto Vallarta, Mexico. Tracy Warren along with Kat Osterman. And top-seeded Oklahoma is on their heels. Back-to-back pitching performances by Lindsay Lopez and Ruby Malin for Washington. And some great offensive production from the Huskies has the Huskies on top 3-2. And Oklahoma will bring in a new pitcher. Peyton Monticelli will come in for Oklahoma. And Nicole May will give way after four innings. Monticelli will take on 3, 4, and 5 for Washington. Riley Holthorff set to lead it off for Washington. High heat. Strike one.
Well, Monticelli is going to come from the right side just like Nicole May, but she throws upper 60s, can hit the 70s. A lot of up spin, but she's been working with Coach Rocha on her command. The ability to control the strike zone and repeat pitches was something that they went to work on this fall after she transferred in from Wisconsin.
Monticelli, just a sophomore, hails from the state of Wisconsin, Peterborough, Wisconsin. As you mentioned, Pat Osterman, a transfer. 6'1", throwing high heat. The 2-2 pitch to Holthorff. Ball up to the left side. Jennings will call for it for the first out of the inning. Cat Osterman surprised that Monticelli has come in given the depth in the circle for Oklahoma, or makes sense because they've got so much to throw at Washington?
It makes sense, in the speed differential of Monticelli from May is significant. May is a lower 60s, spins the ball really well, where Monticelli's upper 60s to 70s. I would have thought we would have seen someone with a little bit more experience come in behind May for this game. But at the same time, Coach Gasso has always done this where she has young pitchers and she will put them in just at the right time to get them enough innings in pressure situations to get that experience that they can build on. That being said, Kirsten Deal, who is set to be the heir apparent after this season, would have been another one I could have thought they would have gone to if they didn't go to Maxwell. But nonetheless, here we see Monticelli, and so far so good.
Ball low in the zone. Monticelli went 7-4 with a 2.71 ERA for Wisconsin last year. She led the Badgers in strikeouts with 82 over 80.1 innings. Walked just 21. Boy, that was a good pitch, but they will call it ball three to Sydney Stewart.
It was a good pitch. Stewart's off the plate, though, so she's running that ball just a little bit inside off the plate to where it is a ball. But the OU fans have been disgruntled a couple times today on some of these pitch calls. But overall, I feel like the home plate umpire has done a good job and been fair both ways.
She's worked a full count. Monticelli against Stewart. Ball up to the left side. Center fielder Jada Coleman will call it and gloves it for out number two.
Well, here is where you see the speed of Monticelli being the difference maker. She's throwing that ball in the inner half to the Washington Huskies, and they're not able to get on time with it. They're a little bit late, so they're getting jammed for these easy fly balls in shallow outfield from both Holthorff and Stewart.
Johnson's going to have to make an adjustment and try to get out in front of this a little bit more. But so far, the switch to Monticelli has paid off.
Alana Johnson sends that foul. How much, Duquette, do you feel? Hey, this is a pitcher who was in the Big Ten last year with Wisconsin. Washington really hasn't had a chance to look at her. Not a whole lot of tape on her, at least inside Pac-12 circles, or at least in NCAA preseason play circles. So, hey, why not just throw her there and see what she can do? She's got to be effective. And right now, she is doing the job for Oklahoma.
She is. She's doing an exceptional job. And for Coach Gasso, too, you have to think about not just the future of this season, but the future moving forward. They go into the SEC after this year, so there's not going to be any games come conference time, and Monticelli's going to be on the staff for three more seasons, so she's going to have to be able to throw against high-powered offenses, and right now doing a really good job of being able to control the strike zone, something she was struggled with a little bit as a freshman.
Well, she's got a lot of poise right now. Taking on Johnson. The 2-1 pitch. Check that. That is strike three. Three up, three down for Monticelli and Oklahoma. He moves to the top of.
This is 36.
This is 38.
This is 35.
A new age in skincare technology.
Seven, eight, and nine set to face Ruby Mabel for Oklahoma here in the top of the sixth. Sid Sanders walked in her first at bat, popped up to the catcher in her second at bat, has home run power. Malin trying to control the most powerful offense in the nation in Oklahoma. They came in last year batting a team 366. Their 117 home runs more than doubled any team in this Puerto Vallarta tournament.
The way the Sooners have been able to put up runs for the last couple years has been so impressive, and there have been very few pitching staffs that have been able to slow them down. But so far tonight, the combination of Lindsay Lopez, she gave up two runs in the first, but then she threw two scoreless. And now Ruby Malin, who has been executing almost to perfection, has kept Oklahoma at bay.
And Sid Sanders has worked a hitter's count. It is 3-1. Sanders up and foul. Well, they say Sid Sanders' dad would help her with her hitting when she was a young athlete. A former Major League Baseball player, helped her learn how to drive the ball, hit with power. Here's the 3-2 pitch.
So far this season, it looks like Sid Sanders will be a mainstay in this lineup for Oklahoma. Her and Ella Parker can switch off at first base. Also have the advantage of putting Hansen or Stewart at first if they need to and giving them a rest from behind the plate.
Ruby Malin came in to spell Lindsay Lopez. She has faced 7 batters. She has struck out 5. We'll go back to the full count against Sid Sanders. Let's see, Walker.
Great battle right there. A big walk for Sid Sanders. Great pitch by Ruby Malin, just a tad inside. That walk gives Oklahoma life. It's gonna take Ruby Malin and the Washington defense to break this momentum, because you give Oklahoma an inch, and a lot of times they don't just take a mile, they take 3 or 4 miles.
Well, that is the first walk given up by Malin. Sid Sanders will likely give way to a pitch runner, and that'll bring up Elena Torres. Torres, as we mentioned, also a transfer from Arizona State, as is Sanders.
Pitch runner at first base for Oklahoma, number 12, Maya Bland.
Maya Bland will pitch run for the Sooners. The freshman out of Argyle, Texas. Torres hitting .500 coming into this at bat. Ruby Malin against Torres. Long fly ball. And that is caught. Tagging is Bland's. And Bland's will move up to second base on the long fly ball by Torres.
Great hustle by Hobson to get over there and make that catch.
Hobson playing left field, the senior. Always amazed at how quickly athletes can adjust. There is no warning track out there. And just finding the fence and getting some perspective. A great defensive play by Hobson. Meanwhile, for Oklahoma, looks like we might have a pitch hitter for the number 9 hitter, Riley Boone. The top of the order, Jada Coleman, is on deck. Bradley Ludlum will replace Riley Boone. Ludlum is a graduate student out of Fort Myers, Florida, transfer from Furman University.
Ludlum, one of the premier catchers that entered the portal in the offseason. Oklahoma looked poised to have a deep catching staff, but Lindsey Elam took off to Tennessee and Jocelyn Erickson then jumped in the portal and ended up at Florida. So Patty Gasso having to grab a catcher who could give Kinsey Hansen a break as season goes on. But Ludlum now getting her chance to get in here and swing the bat in such a close game.
Both Ludlum and Kinsey Hansen are 6 foot. They have a lot of power. The 1-1 pitch, up the middle. Here comes the runner, and we've got a tie ball game. RBI, Riley Ludlum.
You open the door for the Sooners, and they are going to come plowing through. The leadoff walk by Sid Sanders gave them the only momentum they needed. Big pinch hit right there by Riley Ludlum. This is a tie ball game. And the top of the order is coming up. Nada Pullman, who is the heartbeat of this lineup, has a chance now to add to the run total for the Sooners.
So Jada Coleman with the runner on first, trying to keep on the pressure against Ruby Malin. The adjustment by the Oklahoma hitters. They've started to become more patient with Malin. Coleman 1-for-3 on the night.
Deep fly ball in that single are the two hardest hits that OU has had off of Malin. Malin needs to settle down just a little bit, find her rhythm again in order to get out of this inning.
Here's the 2-1 pitch to Jada Coleman. Up in the zone, to the left side. Just out of the reach of Fiedler.
That could be a big break for Oklahoma.
Kat, we talked about how much of an adjustment it is to get used to new fields. Here in Puerto Vallarta, it's just the third game for both of these teams, but still getting used to the field and how much foul territory there is. Jada Coleman has new life. A 2-2 count here in the top of the sixth. Oklahoma has pushed across one this inning to tie it. There is a runner on first. Top of the order. To the left side. And safe all around. Check that. They're going to call her out. It looked like initially they were going to call her safe. And then after the beat, they called her runner out at second base. The fielder's choice for Washington, and now two outs with Ella Parker up.
Coach Gasso out to argue the play. Fielder got the ball quickly, hesitated just a little bit in throwing, and with the speed of Boone, in order for that to be for sure out, you have to be able to transfer and get that out quickly. You can't do a running throw to where you take an extra half step.
Well,
big out right there for the Washington defense.
Yeah, you know, it was new life for Coleman, and then it's almost like they got the call at second for out number two. Either way, they still have to face Ella Parker, who's 0 for 3, has struck out twice, but still has a runner on first here in the top of the sixth. Patty Gasso not done making changes. How much of that do you think is a change, and how much of that do you think is telling the umpire, maybe we want to reconsider that call, although they won't, but I'm sure.
Probably a little of both. She's putting in a pinch hitter here, a right-handed hitter, to take the place with Ella Parker, but at the same time, probably letting the home plate umpire know that she doesn't agree with that call either.
That is Hannah Kaur in the pitch hit. Kaur, the redshirt sophomore out of Yorba Linda, California, Esperanza High School. Got her going up high. Fouls that off. Kaur played in 4 games on opening weekend last season before sustaining a back injury that sidelined her for the rest of the campaign. In 2022, she appeared in 40 games primarily as a pinch runner. Her junior season in high school.
Here.
Yeah. 6-18 hitter as a junior in high school. Malin with high heat. The Sooners get one, and Malin shuts the door on the rest. We've got a tie ball game as we move to the bottom of the sixth. We are knotted.
My dry eyes made me a burning, stinging.
5 times a day.
Makeup smearing, drops user.
I want another option. That's not another drop.
Can't get dry eye relief with drops alone? You could find relief with your own real tears. Tyrvaya, it's not another drop. It's the first and only prescription nasal spray for dry eye. Tyrvaya treats the signs and symptoms of dry eye disease fast by helping your body produce its own real tears. Common side effects include sneezing, cough, and throat and nose irritation.
Relying only on drops? Not me. My own real tears are my relief.
Ask your eye doctor about Tyrvaya, the first and only nasal spray that treats dry eye. See how you can pay as little as $10.
Wow. Well, the Wisconsin wonder, that is Peyton Monticelli, fired up these Sooners. Came in three up, three down to handle the Huskies in the bottom of the fifth, hoping to do the same in the sixth. She will face 6, 7, and 8 for Washington in what is a 3-3 ball game between two top 10 teams in the nation. Monticelli will face Jaden Glad, a 429 hitter coming into today's at bat. 0-for-2 in today's game. Jaden Glab set to lead it off here in the bottom of the sixth.
The question, Tracy, will be if Washington can respond. How do they respond in the bottom half of this inning after OU tying it up?
Last inning, Monticelli got pop up, and strikeout to the 3, 4, 5 hitters of Washington. She now takes on the freshman. She walked him.
Well, we saw the leadoff walk in the top half of this inning be the difference maker, and the Huskies make it be the same for them.
The Huskies have scored 3 runs on 4 hits. They have stranded 5. Oklahoma has scored 3 runs on 5 hits. They have stranded 8. Both teams have used 2 pitchers. Pinch runner for Washington, number 33, Jing Gardner out of Seattle, Washington. The freshman will pinch run. And Patty Gasso talking things over with her infield. How much of this, Kat, do you think is chance for another pitcher to warm up for Oklahoma?
Oh, 100%. I think Oklahoma is going to make a change now with Hobson coming up left-handed. You have Fielder, who also is left-handed at the bottom of this lineup. So Coach Gasso going to provide a different look to try to keep these lefties from getting on and using their speed.
New pitcher for Oklahoma, number 8, Carly Keating.
So the Wisconsin wonder in Peyton Monticelli gives way to Keeney. Carly Keeney, the graduate student out of Providence, Kentucky, a transfer out of Liberty. The third pitcher used today by Oklahoma.
Bikini's first action in a Sooner uniform. As you mentioned, having a successful career over there at Liberty. Coach Gasso talking about how competitive she is. So this is a great situation to put her in. So competitive that when Coach Gasso challenged the pitchers to be athletes and be able to play defense as hard as their infield, Keeney went diving and actually broke a finger that put her out for most of the fall. But the Sooners glad to have her back in the rotation and a big spot here against Washington.
She will face Avery Hobson, who scored Washington's first run. After she walked, she came home on what was an obstruction call called against Kinsey Hansen. It allowed the first Husky run to push across. They added two more in the second. They led Oklahoma until the top of the sixth when Oklahoma got one. Chopped to the left side. They'll go to first and they get the short out in Hobson. Then Gardner moves to second base.
Great job by Hobson to get enough lift on that ball. Got it to hop high enough to give her runner a chance to get a couple extra steps where Brito couldn't make the lead play. Now Washington has a chance to take the lead with a runner in scoring position.
Brooke Nelson has been a hot hitter for the Huskies. She's batting number 8 in this game, hitting .429. She's 1-for-2 in today's game. You mentioned Keeney coming from Liberty, which is coached by former Olympian Doc Richardson, which made their way to the NCAA tournament. Richardson, a former standout shortstop and second baseman for UCLA and the Olympic team. You would think she would teach her pitchers how to play defense.
Well, I'm sure she does. A lot of times, though, pitchers are just a little more tentative. But I'm sure Keeney has been pushed both at Liberty and OU to be able to be another infielder and not just a pitcher and only fielding what's in your view in front of you.
Dot Richardson is very close friends with Patty Gasso and her family. And it is great to see Keeney get life here at Oklahoma. Full count to Brooke Nelson. Runner on second in scoring position. And that will fall in. The runners at first and third here in the bottom of the sixth for the Washington Huskies. Nelson's second single of the day. And as Hansen looks to the dugout, we may have yet another pitching change for Oklahoma. As the number 9 hitter, Kinsey Fiedler, who singled in her last at bat, set to come up for the Huskies, and then the top of the order. It has been over a year since Oklahoma has lost a game. In fact, they lost just one game last year on their way to the national championship.
I have to wonder if Coach Gasso's giving another pitcher time to warm up. Also talking to her infield about if they're going to play in, obviously going to play in and try to cut the run at home.
Kelly Maxwell, the transfer from Oklahoma State, will make her first appearance in this game. And she will relieve Carly Keeney. the fourth pitcher for the Sooners. And Maxwell has runners on first and third here in the bottom of the sixth. Maxwell in from Puerto Vallarta to Mary Nutter. Great Division I college softball, a sport which has really come to the forefront on a lot of people's televisions. Attendance is at an all-time high. Ratings are an all-time high. And Kelly Maxwell has her work cut out for her. The two-time All-American out of Oklahoma State, the transfer, had a 1.58 ERA and struck out 746 batters over nearly 500 innings with Oklahoma State. She's got runners at first and third, one out, and she will face Kinsey Fiedler, the junior lefty. First pitch, they go home. Got her! And Washington, Brooklyn Carter, kind of looking at the home plate umpire, saying she got in. And here comes Heather Tarr. And here comes the replay.
The runner goes on contact, and Kelly Maxwell gets rid of that ball fast, but that's a bang-bang play. I'm not so sure that hand didn't get in there before Kinsey Hansen applied the tag. The throw a little bit low and on the inside of the infield. But a great play by Kelly Maxwell. And without replay review, that call's going to have to stand. But a great job all the way around by the runner and Kelly Maxwell to make that play.
So Patty Gasso and JT Gasso now out talking to the home plate umpire. And we've got top of the order for Washington with two runners on. That is Brooklyn Carter, who is hitting 400. And the umpires are going to congregate as we take another look at the replay.
Oh, slow motion. I think her hand gets in there. It's bang,
I have
bang,
to agree with
you,
Kat.
Looks like it's on her leg. Yeah, that tag looks like it's on her thigh, which puts her hand across the plate. Yeah, her hand's already across the plate right there.
Right there. And the tag comes out afterwards. So Oklahoma gets the out called. It's up to Brooklyn Carter for Washington with two runners on and two outs. Facing Kelly Maxwell.
And here, Tracy, is that lefty-lefty matchup that I thought we might have seen earlier in the game.
Got to be a quick play. Got her. So Oklahoma gets out of the jam thanks to Kelly Maxwell and some great defense by the Sooners. We are not at a three. We're going to the top of the seventh here in Puerto Vallarta.
Avery Hodge gets the flip to first just in time. Brooklyn Carter made that close, but OU escapes a jam.
So Ruby Malin here in the top of the seventh will face 3, 4, and 5 for Oklahoma. And you've got to think, Kat Osterman, they are fired up getting the play at home with the Hansen tag and then getting Brooklyn Carter at first.
Well, two big plays are going to swing the momentum Oklahoma's way. And they already had momentum after tying the game, so they carried it out on defense, made the plays when they have to. Now the question will be, can Ruby Malin reset and keep the Oklahoma offense quiet, or is Oklahoma going to be able to use this momentum, build on it, and possibly win the game?
Well, it will be the toughest part of the Oklahoma lineup. In Jennings, back 429, who has yet to get a hit in today's game, followed by Brito and Hansen. Senior, senior, senior.
I'll just say three seniors, but also three athletes that have come up big for Oklahoma on various occasions. And every time their back is against the wall, somehow the Sooners always seem to get stronger. So regardless of what this game has looked like previously, it's a different situation when they're coming to the end of the game and a game is within reach.
The Oklahoma Sooners, one of the most resilient ball clubs in the country. It's how they've won 3 consecutive national championships. 7 championships spanning the course of 2 decades. Strike one to Jennings.
This is T.R.A. Jennings' second at bat against Ruby Malin. She flew out in her first at bat early in the at bat, so we'll see if she's patient or if she decides to be a little more aggressive in her approach.
To the left side, glove by Fiedler, and they get Jennings. Well, they got Jennings all 4 times in today's game as Washington, and now the number 4 hitter, Alyssa Brito, 0-for-1 in today's game, walked twice, popped out to second in her last at bat.
In my opinion, Alyssa Brito is one of the best hitters at adjusting at bat to at bat. She walked twice against Lopez, was jammed against Malin the first at bat, but I have to imagine that she's ready for that inside pitch if Ruby Malin go there again. I've seen too many times where the pitch that got her out in her previous at bat, she then not only hits it, but hits it incredibly hard in the following at bat.
And just like that, right back up the middle on cue. Brito is a one-out base runner here in the top of the seventh.
Well, Brito didn't hit that inside pitch. She didn't crush it, but she hit it hard enough to get it through. Oklahoma with the go-ahead run on base. Ruby Malin gonna have to be smart. She did strike out Kinsey Hansen and Cassidy Pickering back-to-back in the fifth inning.
Hansen jumping on the first pitch, pops it to third for out number two.
Big situation here for Oklahoma's freshman, although not a pressure situation after the way she started her career. Her approach and her swing is very much like a veteran.
Pickering, one for two on the day. She came into this tournament, hit a grand slam home run in her first at bat. She's got an RBI in this game. The 2-1 pitch, right to.
Great job by Ruby Malin to be able to back-to-back the exact same pitch. Pickering missing the first one, but taking that one, but Ruby Malin just really hammering the zone, not changing until she has to. Great drop balls right there by Malin.
They get her up there, Ruby Malin. Throwing fire upstairs to the freshman. And we move to the bottom of the seventh. The Huskies have a chance to win this ball game. We are knotted at three. Bottom of the seventh, 2, 3, and 4 set to face Oklahoma's Kelly Maxwell. Oklahoma has not lost a game since February of 2023. Killian Felice, strike one. The graduate transfer out of San Diego State is 1-for-2 against Oklahoma.
Celius has the big third RBI for Washington in that second inning. She did strike out in the fourth against Nicole May, but this lefty-on-lefty matchup, Kelly Maxwell so good in these situations.
She's ahead of her 1-2.
We see Celius taking big hacks here against Kelly Maxwell. Bottom of the seventh, Washington just needs a base runner any which way. She doesn't have to leave the yard and win this game on one swing of the bat.
In the dirt, Hansen picks it up, the throw to first, and they get her by a step.
Well, there so you see Maxwell, the big swing by Celius was overpowered with the changeup, or I should say underpowered. Celius was taking big hacks. Kelly Maxwell went with an off-speed pitch in the dirt. And a great job by Hansen to get it to first in time.
Riley Holtwith, the number three hitter, has yet to get a hit against the Sooners. Maxwell takes the signal from Hansen. And that will fall in. Holtwith gets her first hit of this game, and it comes in the bottom of the seventh.
Was so hot for Washington against Utah Valley. Are you able to keep her under wraps until this inning? And really, that's just a ground ball that squeaked by Brito. But if the Huskies can capitalize, they can walk off.
Sydney Stewart has yet to get a hit as Hansen throws to Sanders at first to keep Holtorf close. Stewart yet to get a hit. Boy, wouldn't she love one here. Maxwell tries to go upstairs. She did not go. This is the fourth pitcher for the Oklahoma Sooners. May, Monticelli, Keeney, and now Maxwell. Ball four. And the Huskies have runners on first and second here in the bottom of the seventh with one out.
There was a hitter that I was going to focus on as a pitcher. It would have been Sydney Stewart. Yes, she is in the four hole for Washington, but she does not have a hit on the day. We've been going back to the Utah Valley game. An athlete that's not seeing the ball incredibly well. Kelly Maxwell unable to find the zone. And as you said, Tracy, go ahead, run now, second base.
So, Kat, to your point, They scored Holthorst's shot to third, an error on Brito. It is the third error for Oklahoma. And this is the first time the Sooners have had three or more errors in a game since June 8th, 2021 versus Florida State. And this is a team led the nation in fielding average with a 987 average last year.
Well, that's an impressive run, one, to keep your errors under three a game, but I'm not so sure if that, I would call that hit, that ball an error. I think Holthorst hit it just hard enough, and it's not like it hit off Brito and ricocheted. It almost looked like it went over Herbie Glove. But again, the angle we have and the angle they have there are a little bit different.
First pitch swinging. I agree with you, Kat. From our vantage point, it looked like it was a clean hit down third, just out of the outstretched hand of Brito. But either way, Huskies have two runners on and they're threatening here in the bottom of the seventh.
Well, the other piece of that equation, Tracy, is a lot of times you play in international and the dirt's not the same as what we play on in the state.
And that is Brito who gloves it and gets to force a third for the second out of the inning.
Great job by Brito to cut that off before it got in the hole. Able to get back to third in time. That ball gets through to the 5-6 hole. The only play Holthorst probably has is at first base.
Heather Tarr looks like she's re-entering Jaden Glab, the freshman, who gave way to Jing Gardner, the pinch runner, in her last at-bat after she walked for Washington. So Jaden Glab re-enters. And Maxwell goes to work.
Big hack there by Jaden Glab.
The 1-1 pitch. Ball on the outside. Senior Avery Hobson is on deck. Behind her, hot hitting Brooke Nelson. She goes upstairs and Glab chases it.
That's the situation that as Glab continues in her career, knowing you're ahead in the count, you can zone in on one zone, and up in the zone is not what you're really looking for against Kelly Maxwell.
Kelly Maxwell, with two runners on, sits down Jaden Glab, and we are going extra inning. Maxwell, high, heat, Sooners, moving to the top of the eighth. We are knotted at three. In fact, I push them out of their comfort zone so they learn resiliency, not only on the softball field, but in life. The ultimate teacher, the ultimate professor, Patty Gasso. The Sooners have to feel a little bit uncomfortableness with the Washington Huskies. The Sooners have had to come from behind and tie this game. And now we are in extra innings after the Huskies strand two in the bottom of the seventh. Sid Sanders set to lead it off for Oklahoma, and we will put a runner on second as we go to tiebreaker rules. So Cassidy Pickering will start on second base as the international tiebreaker rules come in. And Sid Sanders up at the plate.
You mentioned it, Tracy. Sid Sanders was the beginning of that rally for OU to come back and tie this, force this game into extras. A leadoff walk. Eventually, her pinch runner came around to score. But she was very patient. Two walks today. She's going to force Ruby Malin to prove she can throw strikes.
You get the feeling Sid Sanders is trying to drive something. You just saw her take that last pitch and buckle her knee with a runner in scoring position. The 1-1 pitch.
I love the way Ruby Malin and Coach Lance Giglasso sneak that rise ball in there. Ruby Malin has a great rise ball, but she's been predominantly down in the zone. But every now and then she'll sneak that high rise ball up in there. OU seeing it, gets excited. A couple really good swing and misses on that for Ruby Malin. She snuck that in there for strike two on Sid Sanders. See if she uses it again in this at bat.
Back up the middle. Malin doesn't check her. The throw to third. Not in time. Ball is dropped. So Pickering is now at third base, 60 feet away. And Sid Sanders at least does her job moving Pickering to set the table for Torres, who in the third inning had a long sacrifice to center field.
I almost wonder if Malin forgot there was a runner at second, because she never once looks over her shoulder. Pickering, realizing that Ruby Malin's not checking her, took off as soon as she pulled her arm back to throw. But if Ruby Malin checks her, I'm not so sure Pickering advances to third on that ground ball.
Torres steps in. So close, so close.
Ruby Malin's been using that drop ball, trying to nibble at the bottom part of the zone. Home plate umpire, though, not budging.
Strike called. The Oklahoma Sooner faithful, they travel everywhere to see their Sooners. Torres. Ball three.
Torres being extremely patient with Malin this at bat. Torres has proven has the ability to get the ball to the outfield off the bats today.
She gets under it, ball to right field, the throw, and that is going to hold Pickering at third base. Two out for the Sooners.
Now batting for the Sooners, number zero, Riley Boone.
Riley Boone comes back in and re-enters the game after Riley Ludlam pitch hit for her in her last at bat. So with two outs, a runner on third, Boone has a chance to push a run across. Goes after the first pitch. That hit Stewart right square in the mask.
I see Ruby Malin checking Stewart, and Stewart saying, I'm good, I promise. But Riley Boone, aggressive on that first pitch.
Stewart saying it with a smile, but Malin just making sure her battery mate is okay. But you're right, Boone coming out swinging. Boone is 1-for-2 on the day. Stewart is okay, he gets a hand. Cassidy Pickering is on third, two outs.
We usually see Riley Boone try to play small ball, run through the box, but she's standing in, gonna take her hacks against Ruby Mayo and miss it back.
And that hack worked. It's a 4-3 ball game, Oklahoma. Go ahead, RBI, Riley Boone.
Ruby Malin staying on the outer half and Riley Boone making the adjustment. You saw her pull off it just a little bit that first pitch. She stays on it that time, drives that to left field. Gives OU the lead, but most importantly, passes the bat to Data Coleman.
The top of the order for Oklahoma. The number one team in the nation, three-time defending champs. They went out to an early lead and Washington responded. It was a 3-2 ball game until Oklahoma pushed one across in the sixth to tie it at 3. Washington threatens in the bottom of the seventh, but could not push the runs across. Here in the eighth, with the international tiebreaker rule, Oklahoma has pushed the first run across, and they've got Riley Boone on first and the top of the order, Data Coleman up, trying to add on more. To the left side, that is playable. And Hobson will catch it for the third out of the inning. But not before the Sooners can plate another one. This one, the go-ahead. We are moving to the bottom of the eighth. Oklahoma now on top, 4-3.
I would tell anybody to enroll in DriveWise, especially families and fathers. Just being a safe driver, I don't even have to think about it. I just get an alert and say, hey, Reed, you'd receive this much money back. I enjoy driving more with DriveWise because I'm saving money.
The Oklahoma Sooners have come from behind and are on top as we move to the bottom of the eighth, 4-3. Washington also now gets to put a runner on second base as part of the international tiebreaker rule. Whoever comes up with more runs here after eight wins, unless again it's a tie ball game. So on second base we'll go Jaden Glad and Avery Hobson will face Kelly Maxwell.
Hobson's done a really good job of putting the ball in play today, has a single to shortstop, ground ball to third base, but with her speed, if she can get it in play, there's a chance that she's safe as well.
And she moves the runner to third, so Glab moves to third. Hobson is the first out of the inning, and that will bring up perhaps the hottest hitter for Washington this game, Brooke Nelson, 2-3, batting .500 for the tournament. First pitch swinging.
Brooke Nelson has been aggressive early in the count, all three at bats today. I'm curious to see how OU pitches her. Both of her hits are to the left side, line drives to left field. Kelly Maxwell tends to stay outside to right-handed hitters. Nelson's gonna have to either adjust and try to go oppo or up the middle, or really get around a pitch. With the speed of Kelly Maxwell, that's hard to do.
And Kelly Maxwell is ahead of her now in the count up to two. Heather Tarr talking to Jaden Glab. She would be the tying runner. Nelson would be the go-ahead, but Maxwell is ahead in the count.
Nice off-speed pitch there by Kelly Maxwell, trying to see if she can get the aggressive Nelson.
Two and two to Nelson. Maxwell goes high again in the zone and Nelson goes for it. Will she tag? She will not. Porras gloves it for the second out of the inning and Oklahoma is one out away from the come from behind victory against Washington.
That was a huge second out, keeping Brooke Nelson in the infield.
It is up to Kinsey Fiedler, who is 1-3 on the evening. And then it's the top of the order for Washington with Brooklyn Carter on deck. Can they get to her? Maxwell against Fiedler.
And it was the same situation for Washington. The nine hole up with two outs. Riley Boone came through, for Oklahoma. Now Washington hoping that same magic can happen for Fiedler here in the nine hole with two outs.
She did not go. 2-1 now to the junior Kinsey Fiedler. The freshman Glab on third. Maxwell going to work. to the left side. Gloved and thrown the first, and Oklahoma comes from behind to beat the Washington Huskies 4-3.
What a game by both sides. Washington Huskies breaking out early. But as we've learned over the last couple years, you can never count the Oklahoma Sooners out. Come from behind to tie it, use extra innings to get the win, all while throwing four different arms in the circle as well. What a great softball game, the first weekend of the 2024 season.
Well, Pat Casco wanted to teach character and getting comfortable with the uncomfortable. And they got that. Brito loving it. Backhand to Sanders. And Homo with a 4-3 win here in Puerto Vallarta. What a fantastic job, as you mentioned, Kat Osterman. And all kinds of players weighing in for Oklahoma. We got the pitch hit from Ridley Ludlam. Coleman led the game off with a single and a run scored. Hansen with the RBI. And Oklahoma does what Oklahoma does, and that is score runs. And Washington gave them a handful. With the obstruction call, Washington had the lead until the Sooners tied it in the sixth and then the go-ahead in the eighth. Oklahoma beats Washington 4-3 here in Puerto Vallarta on a come-from-behind win. And the top-seeded Oklahoma Sooners will remain top seed, and they are fired up. Kat Osterman, four different pitchers for the Sooners. What did you make of the staff since you got to see most of the pitching staff for Oklahoma?
Well, it's really going to come down right now to the seniors. Nicole May led them off. Kelly Maxwell closed the door. They used Monticelli in the middle. Those two are going to have to get a little more experience in pressure situations for Oklahoma. But Oklahoma pitching staff picks up right where it left off in 2024. A couple new faces and new names, but the same success.
Riley Boone had the game-winning hit. Let's hear from her.
What a close game this was.
It was.
Oh, goodness gracious. I thought it was really passionate from both sides. Washington, an amazing team. I think they punch back when we punched, and we punch back when they punch. So from both sides, I thought it was passionate. Really amazing game. It felt like a World Series game.
What is it about this team and the way you guys are able to pull out wins like this one?
Man, I think we just fight. I mean, it doesn't really matter who's on the field. We're going to fight with all we got. And one big thing is that anyone can be up to bat. It doesn't matter if you're a starter or not, but anyone from this bench can get up there and get the job done.
What was the message going into extra innings?
Just calm down. That, you know, it's at the end of the day, it's just a game. And if we're not about results, you know, we're not going to hang our heads or anything. But just, like, calm down and play our game. And don't get riled up, but just play Sooner softball.
Your last at bat, you pretty much won the game for your team. Walk me through that.
Well, I was gonna bunt, but I didn't do that. I really was just thinking about Jesus. I was just saying, like, regardless what's going, you know, I'm literally gonna just think about God. And if I get a hit, thank you, Jesus. If I don't, thank you, Jesus. So either way, I was really just thinking about Jesus and took myself away from worrying about results.
All right, thanks, Riley. Congratulations.
Thank you, Boomer.
Corey, do.
Riley Boone, 2-for-3 and an RBI. The game-winning hit for Patty Gasso and the Oklahoma Sooners as they remain undefeated for 2024. For Kat Osterman and our entire Flow Sport production team, I'm Tracy Warren. This has been a presentation of Triple Crown Sports and Flow Sport. The final score, Oklahoma 4, Washington 3 in 8 innings. We've got a whole new game for you tomorrow. Starting at 10:30 Central Time. For now, so long from Portland, Mallorca, Mexico.